We've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue. But nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Washington football team. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. Start this drive in the air. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck roll that they can fall back on anymore.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Over the middle, into the hands of his tight end, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards the pickup there.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Carry for the USC man, and he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. Deron Payne, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
Brings up second and 7.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. From the shotgun, to give to Jones.
Well, that rate picking up. Yards of carry, you and I both know that doesn't cut it in this league and trying to get first downs unless you're playing 4-down football. Then that's a whole different situation, but I don't think that's what they're trying to do here. 3rd and 4, though, is still manageable.
An extra man here in the secondary for Washington on 3rd down. This time for Miller. This is intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
45 to Mike. 45 to Mike. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Tackle made that time by Vita Vea.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
On third down, Mayfield. Open man is Sims. He's got it. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. They give him 16 yards there, and it's a Washington first down.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
And he powers his way up past the 30.
He's brought down.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
From the 31, Mayfield. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground.
55.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. Yeah, he'll find Hall. And now nothing but green ahead of him. Touchdown, Washington.
Touchdown.
A big play there.
Yeah, yeah,
69 yards. And Washington has taken a first quarter lead. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. He's going to go up top again. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
Now Baker going to keep this himself. He'll pitch it back. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. 27 yards. And Washington going to add on to their lead. You don't see option pitches a whole lot in the NFL, but there worked out pretty well, resulted in a touchdown.
And it's hard for defenses because they don't see it very often, so the time in preparing each week is probably minimal. So when it comes at them, it's often a surprise. And what a nice job on the read, pitch to the running back, and he takes it all the way in for a touchdown.
And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. Space to maneuver at the 40. The catch made by Miller. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 33 yards that time.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
First down, he'll drop to throw it. And this one is incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's second down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. They'll look to throw. Open man is Godwin. It's complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Buccaneer first down.
Zone now. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke.
The first down pass. Intercepted. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Second quarter now from our nation's capital, and it's Washington in possession of the football as they've got it with a second and 3 forthcoming. It's Geis on the counter. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
Going to get this one down to the 45.
To the running back.
And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. They'll set up the screen for Gibson. Mayfield. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Mayfield now from the 50. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Looking downfield for Godwin. And it's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. It's a big play there for the Buccaneers. And even 50 yards. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And give him about 3 as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
The 22-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. He'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off down at the 10. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown 4 picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw 4 in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
Brings up second and three at the 25-yard line.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. From the gun, Mayfield. And this is incomplete. Antonio Gibson, the intended target. And it's third and short.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Washington on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and three. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they're into the end zone, but it's not verified yet. Hold on, there is a flag down. Brutal, so take away the long touchdown.
It's a cruel game sometimes, partner.
So following the holding call, what can they do here on third and long?
Alert!
Mayfield looks to throw. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Going to the air again with Mayfield. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And the throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Mayfield off the play fake. And he'll get this to Antonio Gibson, complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll try and get it with Geis, and flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. Now let's check on the call. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, he can't hold him.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. He'll return it from the six. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Bucs are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. The
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. Here comes the Buccaneers punter now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And taken at the 46. So a change of possession here on the punt. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. And it is good. Oh, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way, but it does get over the bar. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Taking it about the one. And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. That holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
This is Geis. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Quick throw, and Mayfield completes it. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming. The Bucs with an extra defender now in the secondary here on third down. Here's Mayfield. He's going to rifle one deep left side into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. But pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
Go. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And my goodness, another interception. Picked by Kendall Fuller. And he will bring this all the way up to the 30-yard line. That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
Second and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Mayfield to throw it. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They go play action. Mayfield. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know, there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin too.
So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack. You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And he'll get this up to the 4 right about there, and that's about it. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Brings up second and 7 at the 4-yard line.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Control of the line of scrimmage created a big gain.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
Back to throw now on first down. And he finds Howard complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
To O.J. Howard.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Troy Apke. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception. And I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around a defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Brings up 2nd and 8.
Now Mayfield. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Mayfield now. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Marcus Davenport able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon. Here's Tressway now. Back now at FedEx Field as we are just about set to go here in quarter number 4. Here's Tressway now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Taken at about the 16. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this 4th quarter. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last 2 drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
What do you think, Brandon? I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle.
And that will be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
On is the punter man as he boots this one away. Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And this is really the start to the season that you're hoping for if you're a coach or a player. They've got the big lead here in the fourth quarter. And he's into the clear. The 30, 10. So they hit pay dirt, but don't count it yet. There's laundry on the field. We'll see what the penalty flag is about. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
So fourth quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks, and keep the clock moving as well. So they'll run their offense, but yeah, when they have a chance to run it, they'll do that a little bit more.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now a run with Geis. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brings up second and 9 at the Bucks 48-yard line.
To throw, Mayfield. The throw taken in by Sims. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 37. It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They're going to run this with a tight end. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
On the draw, they go to Geis. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Okay, just like that.
On second and 12, Mayfield. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They're going option play on third down. A quick toss outright. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
And this one is right down the middle. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. Back now on EA Sports. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's Washington that scoops it up.
As that ball got away from him and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Second and nine.
And they'll indeed take a knee. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long.
Three down. Mike 5-9.
And they will take a knee here. So it's Washington getting the victory here. And this was truly a total team effort, Charles, on both sides of the ball.
Well, they absolutely pitched a shutout, so it can't get much better than that, right? The defense led the way, but the offense did their part as well. They moved the ball up and down the field. So you've got to like what you saw. What do they call that? A total team effort? I think when it's time to hand out game balls, guys from both sides will end up getting one.
So for Washington, you can't ask for a better start as they pitch a shutout here in the opener. And they'll have another home date next week as the New York Giants come to town. Meanwhile, for the Bucs, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll try again next week at home against Philadelphia. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.